Hello dear friends, today I will show you how I installed front parking sensors on my Seat Leon Mark III. The same procedure can be used for other vehicles from the Volkswagen group. Stay tuned. This procedure can be applied to vehicles that already have rear sensors installed, for example, the Golf 7 or Octavia. After completing this installation, you will have front sensors installed in a way that matches how they are factory installed in these vehicles. The first thing I will do is replace the parking sensor control module. The module is located at the front on the left side near the driver. The replacement is simple, you need to unclip the plastic hooks. You have the list of parts in the video description as well as some links that are useful in the process. This is the new module, in fact it is used but has the capability to connect to front sensors and is suitable for this vehicle. In addition to the new module and sensors, you will also need a speaker for the front sensors, a switch for the central console and cables to connect everything. In this existing connector, the pins for the speaker and switch need to be inserted into positions 2 and 10 for speaker and positions 16 and 17 for switch respectively. Here you can see the completed wiring of the connector. Here both connectors for the front and rear sensors are connected to the control module. A speaker for the front sensors can be placed here. Now it is necessary to route the cables for connecting the front sensors from the cabin to the engine compartment. For this purpose, I will try to attach a wooden stick to the cables so that they can be pushed through to the engine compartment. This is the location where other cables from the cabin go towards the engine compartment, and the cables for the sensors need to pass through the same passage. You should be cautious to avoid damaging any of the existing cables. Take your time and ensure the new cables are routed carefully. This is the view from the engine compartment showing where the cables should appear. In the end, I had to use a metal rod instead of a wooden stick. I glued the cables to the metal rod so I could pass them through this hose. Now I will connect the cables to the sensor cable connector. This couldn't be done earlier because it wouldn't have been possible to pass the cables through to the engine compartment. This connector needs to be connected to the sensor connection cable. Then we can connect the sensors to the ends of this cable. The connection is simple, just squeeze until you hear a click. Now the bumper needs to be removed to install the sensors. Details of this process won't be shown in this video, but you can check another video linked for details on removing the front bumper. The process is quite simple, just unscrew all the bolts and remove the bumper. Now we can locate the positions on the interior of the bumper where the sensors should be placed. These spots are marked with a plus sign, indicating where holes need to be drilled for the sensors. This is a special tool used for drilling holes for the sensor. It allows for precise drilling and the result is very good. To use the tool, you will need two wrenches, size 13. It's important to position the smaller part of the tool on the outside of the bumper. Before placing the tool in the bumper, drill a small hole with a drill so that the tool can be inserted. Use one wrench to hold one screw and the other to tighten. Once it's tightened enough, the tool will make a hole in the bumper. The result is very good, much better than making a hole with a regular drill. I glued the sensor brackets with this strong double-sided tape. Here's what it looks like when the sensor is placed in its position. The central console needs to be removed to install the parking sensor switch. This switch comes as standard equipment in models that have both front and rear sensors installed at the factory. For removing the console, it's best to use a plastic tool positioned as shown in the picture to unclip the hooks from the bottom that hold the console. Then carefully unclip other hooks from sides and from the top of the console, and console will be removed. To remove all switch from central console, first unclip wires connector and then unclip plastic hooks that holds switch in position. This is my new switch for central console. It contains switch for parking sensors. It has different connector with more pins, and I will need to rewire existing connector with pins for turning on or off parking sensors. You can see on picture how to connect pins on new switch. Pin 16 from control module should be connected to pin 9 on switch, and pin 17 from control module should be connected to pin 8 on switch. Other pins from old switch should be connected on same pins like on the old switch. The last step is to check and, if necessary, adjust some parameters on the new parking sensor control module. Three parameters need to be checked and possibly set. The first one you can see on the screen, and it is vehicle path display. The second one is optical parking system active. The third one is in the other module. You need to close the currently open module and open the instrument module. Check the option Park Steer Assist installed. Make sure it is checked, saved, and close the diagnostic tool. With this step, setting is complete. Thank you.